Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to my YouTube channel Calculus and Mathematics Learning. In the previous video, we commenced and started with exercise number 3.4 related with chapter number 3, Variation. In that exercise number 3.4, there are total 8 questions in which we 4 questions already solved, and the remaining 4 questions 5, 6, 7 and 8 is going to solve today. So question number 5 tells that if prove that each of the fraction in x plus y over a plus b is equal to y plus z divided by b plus c is equal to z plus x divided by c plus a. There are three fraction here. They tells that prove that each of the fraction out of these three fraction, all of the three fraction will be equal to x plus y plus z divided by a plus b plus c. So solution, using the K theorem which we started in exercise number 3.4, that K theorem is solved using here. So x plus y divided by a plus b is equal to y plus z divided by b plus c is equal to z plus x divided by c plus a. Let's suppose these all are equal to k. So taking x plus y where a plus b is equal to k, also taking y plus z divided by b plus c is equal to k, and also z plus x divided by c plus a is equal to k. Shift a plus b to right hand side, it becomes x plus y is equal to k time of a plus b. Here shift b plus c to right hand side becomes y plus z is equal to k time of b plus c. Using the same logic here, z plus x is equal to k time of c plus a, will shift to right hand side, it becomes c plus a. Now using the rule of mathematics that if we doing something on the right hand side, the same process will do on the right hand side, on the left hand side. So x plus y add with y plus z and add with z plus x on the left hand side. On the right hand side, add k into a plus b, add it with k into b plus c, and add with k time of c plus a. X plus x gives us 2x, y plus y gives us 2y, z plus z gives us 2z. Here taking k common from k into a plus b plus k into b plus c plus k into c plus a. So by taking k common inside, we are left with a plus b, b plus c, and c plus a. So taking 2 common from here, so inside we are left with x plus y plus z, and here it becomes k time of a plus a gives us 2a, b plus b gives us 2b, and c plus c gives us 2c. Solving here, so 2 time of x plus y plus z is equal to, taking 2 common from here, so it becomes 2k. Inside we are left with a plus b plus c. Cancelling 2 on the right hand, left hand side, so we are left with x plus y plus z is equal to k divided by k into a plus b plus c. Dividing both sides with a plus b plus c. So on the right hand side, it will cancel out with each other. So we are left with k is equal to x plus y plus z divided by a plus b plus c. We suppose x plus y over a plus b is equal to y plus z over b plus c is equal to z plus x over c plus a is equal to k. These all are equal to k. So putting the value of k, which is this. So put here, it becomes x plus y divided by a plus b is equal to y plus z divided by b plus c is equal to z plus x divided by c plus a is equal to x plus y plus z is equal to a plus b plus c. So these all is equal to x plus y plus z divided by a plus b plus c. Hence we prove. And last we written, hence we prove. Move to question number 6 of exercise number 3.4. Question number 6 tells that if bz plus cy divided by b minus c is equal to cx plus az divided by c minus a is equal to ay plus bx divided by a minus b, then prove that a plus b plus c multiplying x plus y plus z will be equal to ax plus by plus cz. Using K theorem, taking bz plus cy divided by b minus c, this whole is equal to k. Let's suppose cx plus az divided by c minus a will also be equal to k. Let's suppose, and ay plus bx divided by a minus b is also equal to k. shift b minus c to the right hand side, it becomes bz of plus cy is equal to k time of b minus of c. Using the same property here, it becomes cx of plus az of is equal to k time of c minus a. Here it becomes ay plus of bx is equal to k time of a minus b. Now we are required to a plus b multiplies x plus y plus z gives us ax plus by plus of cz. Now taking a plus b plus c multiplying x plus y plus z. From here we are going to prove that multiplication of a plus b plus c into a plus y plus z must be equal to a plus by plus z. So multiplying a with x, it gives us ax. Multiplying a with y, it gives us ay. Multiplying a with z, it gives us az. Multiplying b with x, it gives us bx. Multiplying the same b with y, it gives us by. Multiplying c b with z, it gives us bz. Multiplying c with x, it gives us cx. Plus c multiply y gives us cy. Plus c multiply z gives us cz. Now we have bz plus cy is equal to k time of b minus c. So by bz plus cy. Where is bz? Bz is here. Plus cy. It gives us k time of b minus c, put here. Also cx plus az. This is cx plus az. This is equal to k time of c minus a. Plus ay plus bx. This is ay and this is bx. Its sum is equal to k time of a minus b. And we are left with ax plus by and plus cz. So kb minus kc plus kc minus ka plus ka minus kb plus ax plus by plus cz. kb will cancel out with negative kb, ka will cancel out with negative a, and kc will cancel out with negative kc. So we are left with ax plus by plus cz. So we prove that product of a plus b plus c multiplying x plus y plus z gives us ax plus by plus cz. Hence we prove. Move to question number 7 of exercise number 3.4. Question 7 tells that if x over b plus c minus a is equal to y divided by c plus a minus b is equal to z divided by a plus b minus c, then prove that b minus c time of x plus c minus a time of y plus a minus b time of z must be equal to 0. In this question, we make the substitution using K theorem. So the answer and the question will become very difficult. So how can we make it easier? By using the substitution. Let's suppose x over b plus c minus a is equal to y divided by c plus a minus b is equal to z divided by a plus b minus c is equal to 1. Let's suppose it is equal to 1. So x will be equal to shift b plus c minus a to right hand side to multiply with 1. It gives us b plus c minus a. And here shift c plus a minus b to right hand side, it becomes a c plus a minus b. And here shift a plus b minus c to right hand side, it becomes z is equal to a plus b minus c. We are going to prove b minus c time of x plus c minus a time of y plus a minus b time of z must be equal to 0. So b minus c multiplying x, x is b plus c minus a, put here b plus c minus a plus c minus a multiplying y is c plus a minus b, put here plus a minus b time of z. Z is equal to a plus b minus c. Now multiply by b with b, it gives us b square. B with c, it gives us bc. B with a, it gives us negative ab. C with b, it gives us minus cb. C with c, it gives us negative c square. C with a, it gives us ac. Multiplying c with c, it gives us c square. Multiplying c with a, it gives us ac. Multiplying c with b, it gives us minus cb. Multiplying a with c, it gives us minus ac. Multiplying a with a, it gives us negative a square. Multiplying a with b, it gives us plus ab. Plus o. Multiplying a with a square, a it gives us a square, a with b it gives us ab, a with c it gives us negative ac, b with a it gives us negative ab, and b with b it gives us negative b square and b with c it gives us plus bc. Now we are going to cancel, so minus ab plus ab will cancel out, minus cb will cancel out with bc, minus c square will cancel out with c square, ac will cancel out with negative ac, and this ac will cancel out with this negative ac, ab will cancel out with negative ab, and b square will cancel out with negative b square, and minus bc will cancel out with plus bc. We are left with a square and minus a square. It will cancel out with each other, and we are left with no term because all the term here is cancelled. So it means that b minus c multiply x plus c minus a multiply y plus a minus b multiply z is equal to 0. So hence we prove. Move to the last question of today, exercise number 3.4 related to chapter number 3, variation. Question number 8, which is the last question of today, exercise tells that if 2x plus 3y ratio 3y plus 4z ratio 4z plus 5x is equal to 4a minus 5b ratio 3b minus a ratio 2b minus 3a, then prove that 7x plus 6y plus 8z is equal to 0. According to the fresh new course of KPK board class 10, this question is new. According to the fresh new course. So, solution. You know that in mathematics, if we something do on one side, the same process will do on the other side. So, let's suppose we add this ratio on the right hand side, on the left hand side. So, the same process will do on the right hand side. So, we will add this ratio on the right hand side. Let's suppose 2x plus 3y add with 3y plus 4z. Plus 4z plus 4x. So add the 3 ratio on the right hand side and also act the same process on the right hand side. Add these 3 ratio in itself. So 4 in themselves. So 4a minus 5b plus 3b minus a plus 2b minus 3a. Here 2x plus 5x it gives us 7x. 3y plus 3y gives us 6y. And plus 4z plus 4z it gives us 8z here. 4a minus a minus 3a it gives us 0. Minus 5b plus 3b plus 2b it gives us 0. So 7x plus 6y plus 8z is equal to 0. Hence we prove that 7x plus 6y plus 8z is equal to 0. With this question, exercise number 3.4 is complete. The next video we inshallah solve exercise number 3.5. Thank you for watching, subscribe my channel and also hit the bell icon for the latest and upcoming videos of mathematics. Thank you.